cause I got shit to lose. A nigga out here paying his dues. My baby walking, gotta get him some shoes. It's a new game brewing. Let me give you the rules. Get out of line and I'ma give you the blues. It's a new game brewing. Let me give you the rules. Get out of line and I'ma give you the blues.
Whoa! Guess who's been that? The boy B Mizak, aka Mr. Crack a Brick. Turn a whole one from a half a brick. Look, I mastered this. You can smell it once the plastic hits. Hot play to make it swell up. If your gasket click, you can make your chip swell up. You don't have to pitch. Play them corners like a safety. Watch the traffic switch. Young and never punk fake. And you'll get past the blitz. And keep your whole hood on flip. Like old box spring, pissy mattress shit. No, won't box a thing. Strictly blasting shit. I hug the block like quarter water. Shit, I used to hug the corner like an old deuce in a quarter. To like deuce in the morning with the old heads. Slinging loose quarters. This Philly cat back at it. Still fucking with them crack addicts. Still bustin' with that black paddy.
Guess who's Bizak? Back on the block with them O's. Face mob, Mac, mittens, and hoes. Don't make me relapse. Back to the block with the foe. Cause the street shit is all I know.
Oh, hey, hey,
what's good?
Hey, 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 y'all know that sound? Thank you, thank you, thank you, y'all too kind, y'all too kind, too kind, much too kind.
Yo, yo, yo.
Yeah, much too kind. Welcome back, y'all. Happy 2024. We in the building, the Bourbon Brothers. Today's show is powered by Elijah Craig, single barrel, 18 year.
You wish you had some of that.
Yeah, man. Yes. It's a celebration. It's a celebration. Yeah.
That's it.
Man. So this is a special edition of Conversations. That's T-Rex over there.
I'm putting that in my cup.
Yeah, man.
Is my mic the only mic that's not working?
Your mic on.
Your mic on.
Oh, my headphones ain't working.
Turn
it loud and clear.
Yeah, we got to. We say what? Don't say that live on the air. It is not the engineer's fault.
Take two.
And we're back.
Yeah, man.
What's up, my brothers?
Yo, man. Yo,
back.
Everybody, you can hear the smiles in everybody's voices, yeah, man. You can hear the smiles.
Great location.
Yeah, the new location.
The new location in the nation. Best location in the nation.
Man, absolutely.
As Big Chuck and Lil John would say.
Yeah,
Chuck and Houlihan.
If y'all watching right now live on YouTube and Twitch and the website, y'all get a sneak preview of one of the corners. You know,
just the new empire.
Grand opening coming soon.
Yeah, y'all hold tight.
Very soon.
We received y'all calls and text messages. Hold tight.
Yeah,
make sure we got enough space for y'all. It's real tight in here.
We in the shoebox now, but it's okay.
Yeah, but you know, everybody's welcome when it's time. When it's time.
Basement. We're in the attic. Everybody else already in the basement.
This is
we're gonna,
true.
We're going to be shoulder to shoulder, but we're going to be all right.
But no more Green Mile, though.
No more Green Mile hallway. No more Green Mile. But your knees better work.
Yeah.
You better have knees like Megan.
You're right about that. That Stairmaster going to get you together.
You better have knees like Megan.
That was good.
That was right on time.
Yeah.
Can I get some volume on my mic, engineer? A little bit.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just my headphones.
I think it's my, because I hear everybody else. Let me stop.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, we're still working.
This is impromptu. You know? Yeah. This is impromptu.
Let's run the commercial.
There you go.
They thought this is impromptu, man.
Okay.
Yeah. We didn't even get the stylist in, man. Ain't nobody do our makeup or nothing.
No makeup yet.
Right.
Gotta get my haircut. Great day on the for next week.
Fresh line.
Fresh line up.
Yeah, we got a barber chair for you. Come on up here.
Ooh, my goodness. Imagine that.
Yeah. Looks good in here, man.
Yeah.
Floor shining. Wet.
That's a beautiful picture, man.
It is.
That is a beautiful picture.
Oh, damn. That's a dope ass picture, yes.
That is a beautiful picture, man.
Yeah.
Looking like new money.
That's it.
This can't be life.
Yeah. This can't be life.
No, this is life. No bullshit. This is life.
Hey, so I want to say super duper happy birthday. Shout out to Big Hef.
Big Hef, happy birthday.
Happy birthday, brother.
Yeah.
You're an old man now.
You're almost 50, I think.
Stop it. Okay. Good for him. Good for him. Good for him.
Black don't crack. He wears it well.
Yeah, that's,
that, that's good shit, though.
He got some history in the city.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah.
Absolutely.
Second generation Ohio players in the house.
Is that I believe good? I still have that CD. I have that CD. Wow.
Yeah.
I might have that vinyl, too.
Damn. Yeah, they did a freestyle on one of my first mix CDs.
Yeah.
Him and Paulie Ron.
Matter of fact,
oh, wow.
I do
you
have that 12-inch.
You digging for real. Wow.
I have that 12-inch.
Yeah.
Oh, you should bring that to the next party.
Yeah. I know that CD. I know exactly where that CD is, too.
Yeah. Yeah, they used to roll like the and Wu-Tang Clan and
yeah.
Damn.
I remember they had a van or something, too, like this huge van.
Yeah. They was official.
Yeah.
Okay. They was official.
I remember that.
Okay.
Yeah, shout out to the city, man.
Yeah.
Shout out to the city.
Cleveland, we're back.
Yeah, shout
back
out.
Back up and running.
Shout out to y'all, man.
Doing stages, all, baby. Stages.
Stages and
phase one.
Staying focused.
Yeah.
You know, getting things done. Starting new shit. All of that.
It's been a grind, man. Was November was the last show?
Yeah. The week before Thanksgiving, I think it was.
Yeah,
right.
Shut down all of December, so we had to pay that rent. Now we don't have to pay rent no more. No.
Say
we
it.
Own the bitch.
Say that.
Then when the gunshot said, pop, 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 pop.
We own the bitch. Fuck it.
It's mine.
We got a mortgage note, man.
Yeah, they ain't want to give us a break, so we had to break away.
Woof.
Yeah.
That's real.
Yeah.
That's
real. So, you know, it's just been one of those things, man. You know, it's funny because it's like we talk about a lot of initiative and changes in the city, and it's been a whole lot of changes for the better. And, you know, we just wanted to come on here today and, you know,
touch
bring y'all in the fold, so to speak.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Right. We're not bringing back the World Famous Clubhouse show as of yet, but it will be some future dates coming. We just, this
something,
is
something to that effect. But,
yeah, like we said, this is just impromptu, so. We're doing this, so, you know, just to touch base with y'all, let y'all know.
We're still active.
Yeah.
We're still active.
We're still building.
And changing direction. Changing lanes, but still going the same direction.
Yeah. We're planting the seeds of tomorrow, man. Planting the seeds of tomorrow.
Literally.
Yeah.
Literally.
So I won't go into too much detail with that. But I will go into detail with some things that I want to talk about on Conversations. And today is one thing I want to talk about because I know that everybody's wrapped up in this whole political thing. And I am not a political person.
We got one. Come on, T-Rex. Come on, what you got?
So it's crazy that I want to bring back neighborhood initiatives.
That's a great idea, though.
Yeah, I think this is something I think we should start focusing on things that we can actually do as constituents. As Ohioans, as Clevelanders.
Making change that we can see.
That we can control.
Yeah, right.
That we can actually control. Like, I think everybody who lives in an urban neighborhood, like, you should talk to your neighbors. You should talk to the people on your streets. You should find out what streets don't have street lights working.
That's the only way you're going to know what's going on.
Yeah. I think you need to petition your councilmen in the neighborhood to make sure that all the street lights are working. I think we need to start a street light.
It has to be stuff that makes sense, too, though. You know,
right.
Don't come up with dumb shit.
Well, we're coming
up. I hate to say it like that, but.
Well, we're getting ready to go into a season. And the season that we're going into is summer and spring. And we all have grandbabies. We all have, you know, fresh nieces and nephews. And we want to give them the part of life that we had. Like in the 80s, we were our own stuntmen. You know what I mean? We survived
this
the 80s.
Is true. Right.
We got
right,
educated right. in the 90s, and we just stumped through the 2000s. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like
right.
by the 2000s, the game was changed.
We knew enough.
Yeah, but we were whole ass stuntmen in the 80s.
Yeah.
Jumping ramps with our bikes with no supervision, jumping off garages. Back flipping off of mattresses.
Driving cars with no brake lines.
Yeah,
all
you know,
kind of stuff.
We were some real stuntmen. You know, if you grew up in the 80s, you know, you understood what that was about. You know what I mean? You earned
made
the stripes.
It through the 80s.
Yeah, you made it through the 80s. You got some scars.
Yeah,
you
made it. Yeah.
You got some scars.
Yeah.
Like my favorite line from American Gangster when Denzel is talking to his cousin, he's saying, "Fuck it, let's go."
Yeah.
That was us.
That was the 80s.
That was us. Fuck it, let's go.
Yeah, y'all got to get y'all kids off the couches and off them cell phones and outside. Like, buy them a bike,
please.
Go bike riding with them. Y'all need to, and you know what, I gotta be, it's weird. This is the one thing where I'm talking about with these initiatives. And the initiatives have to be super important because if we don't push these initiatives, We can't make any changes.
Right.
So if
right.
we can get the people to start talking about turning on their porch lights at night, getting the street lights in on the streets fixed and turned on, like, these are the politics that we can control. These are the things that's within our power.
Yeah.
So, I mean, just as far as attending some of these meetings and finding out what's the budget for your neighborhood, your ward. Like, there's a budget set aside for every ward. But yeah, if people don't attend those meetings, they won't know.
Right.
So with that money that comes into your ward, this is how y'all could bring back the family function and rebuilding and bonding of the neighborhood. You could rebuild your whole village, but you have to get involved.
You got to be part of them stepping stones.
Yeah, you got to get involved. Yeah. So, you know, when you got potholes in your neighborhood that's been there for 20 years and you see that truck pull up and they just put the same tar back in there and then 6 months later, yeah, that hole is back.
Right.
Like, you have control over that.
Yeah. You can complain about that.
Yeah.
You can go to city hall meetings, voice your opinion. You go to enough meetings, and before you know it, you're part of the city hall.
Absolutely.
You have to know to ask the correct questions, you know. You know, like you're saying with potholes, you ask the questions, of course, when it's going to be repaired. So they'll give you the quick, we're going to fill it. But you find out what the schedule is, you know, for street repairs, you know,
right.
resurfacing.
Right.
You know, you got to know what to ask, you
right.
know.
Yeah. Don't bring the barrels out and wait till the wintertime.
Right, yeah, because they could pacify you real quick.
Yeah.
October.
Right, they're at the end of the summer.
Right, right.
You done broke 18,000
tie rods.
Tie rods.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Wheel alignments. I'm like, give me a wheel alignment shop in this one.
But the crazy part is what people should be upset about this year with the way the taxes is structured. Y'all should be kicking down doors of y'all politicians and asking a shit ton of questions, because how you work for a company all these years and all of a sudden 2023, they ain't take no federal taxes out.
Right.
And now everybody owe thousands of dollars. This is a conversation that
people
not having these conversations.
And
this has been happening.
It's your fault.
And they blaming it on the employees.
Certain jobs, certain places.
Yeah.
You already, the year before you had taxes coming out.
Yeah, you had taxes coming out. But for 2023, all of a sudden, they forgot to take out federal taxes.
Oh, hell. So,
and when you go to resolve it, you get penalized for
it. Of course.
It's 100% on you, even though your company, HR, payroll department.
But all of a sudden, you become 1099 real quick.
Yeah, they didn't take out none of those taxes.
Republicans.
But they take out state taxes, though.
Yeah, but no federal.
Everybody's supposed to take out federal.
There's a couple places
I know,
like
no,
that
I'm saying, like, who do we complain to? I mean, of course, the job, but, like, the state taxes is automatic, but how come the federal is not automatic?
Well, the problem is that with state taxes, like, this is the most money that people have ever got back from the state. Mm-hmm. People are getting, like, thousands of dollars back from state, which is almost unheard of.
Yeah, me too. Yeah.
So, but everybody owe when it comes to federal. Mm-hmm. Squirt in the building.
Hey, baby. DJ Squirt,
mate.
Where the food at?
It's on the way.
Stop it. She like, where the food at?
Been ages.
Just November.
Just walking up St. Clair. We just blew our horn at you.
Right. It's better.
You get out of here what you call me.
Strictly Apple.
What are we talking about?
Strictlyapple.com.
We're talking about politics.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's been the whole thing. And it's like it's been a lot of small shorts on TikTok, Instagram, and Facebook about companies not taking out federal taxes for 2023. Cause all everybody owes like in the 4 to 5 thousands and up.
That's insane.
I wish that's insane. All I owe.
But okay.
But you know what? Things that's been happening that people haven't been paying attention to is that a lot of companies have been switching over to digital payroll
to eliminate the taxes.
So I mean, eliminate paper trails.
Paperwork, yeah.
So that's how people are losing track of it, because the average employee just say, well, hell, I can go on ADP, but the only time the average employee going on ADP or a HOLA is when they're going to buy a car.
So let me ask you something.
Yeah.
You see your check. You know how many hours you work, right?
Absolutely.
You know how much you get paid, right?
Absolutely.
If something pops up and you getting more money, are you asking questions?
Negative.
Okay. Oh, so you ain't asking questions?
No.
That's part of the problem.
But that's being honest, though, because the average.
You're not going to ask questions?
Well, I would ask. Yeah, me personally, yes. I ask questions.
Yeah,
absolutely, right. Because I want to know.
Especially when you look at the breakdown.
Wait a minute.
You're getting this extra $100, $200.
Right. And, like, how?
And I didn't do no overtime.
Right. Like, where did this come from?
Yeah. Like, y'all about to slide some stuff on me.
Yeah, so, but I think. But what's happening is that companies are starting to get in trouble because people are starting to complain. And as they should. Like, if your company do not withhold federal taxes for your employees, the company should have to pay their tax debts.
No shit. Yeah.
That's just, yeah, it's just by right. It's just the right thing to do. Will it happen or not? We don't know.
But like you said earlier, if we're not going to these meetings and complaining, you're never going to fix it.
Absolutely. So when you get that tax letter in the mail, the tax bill in the mail.
Yeah, it's going to be a bill.
Right. Yeah.
It's accumulating the 1st and the 15th of every month.
Yep.
Adding interest on your ass.
Yep. So what you
those are the dates, the 1st and the 15th.
Yeah. So what essentially start out as a $4,000 bill after penalties on the first month, you're talking about a $6,000 to $7,000 bill.
Yeah.
Just on penalty and interest over something that was not your fault because you don't work in accounting or HR on your job. Right, right. So you're not aware of what's going on.
And those type of things have to be addressed immediately.
Yeah, absolutely.
You can't let it sit.
Well, and I only know about it because, like, one, it happened to one of the guys on the job, and the guy went to the State Department, the IRS, and they said, well, it's your responsibility to know what your tax is. He said that our company is going 100% digital. He said, well, if I was you, I would definitely be having a long talk with HR because you shouldn't be footing this bill if you don't actually get your paperwork. So they dropped the ball without making sure that you are in the know of maintaining your pay stubs. Because that's every company's job. Like, I don't care where you worked there for years. If you didn't, even if you got a direct deposit, your check company always gave you your stub. Yep. So the moment they stopped giving your stub is the moment that they took accountability for not keeping you in the know of what's going on. So it's technically not the person's fault, but if you're not proactive about it, you don't know what to do about it.
Because I know if his check came up short, I'm sure he asked the questions too.
But the whole thing is when there's failures and flaws in HR and accounting, then it becomes a problem within the company, not your problem because that's not your job.
Yeah.
So it's about
true. Fill out your deductions at the beginning of every year. Unless you don't want to change it.
But it's a problem.
But you should have an option.
The company is supposed to ask you.
Yeah.
Every year from my retirement, do you want to change your deductions?
Yeah.
I wish I would have changed it.
Yeah, because a lot of people say take an extra $200 out and
set aside for that.
Yeah.
And if you don't, they also tell you upon hire, how many people deductions are you going to claim in payroll? Mm-hmm. That's for state and federal. Right. So if they pull your hire packet up and you check that and the company didn't take out those taxes, you got a major lawsuit on your hand.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So,
and then the company's getting all these breaks.
Yeah.
But then there's you know, on the opposite side, when I was working, you know, during a leaf season, we would, for those 6 weeks, a lot of us would go up there and change and add, you know.
Because you're getting the overtime.
Because you're getting overtime. So, you know, give me more of my money.
Yeah, the more you make, the more they're going to take.
You know you're going to be penalized on the back end, but you want it right now.
Absolutely.
So, they keep up with it all day long, you know. Mm-hmm. And it's no escaping it.
Yeah, that's some of the things. Like, I want to start crusading more for neighborhood change. Like, mm-hmm. I want to start, like, almost a seed foundation of change in urban neighborhoods. Like, in every ward, I want to change that narrative. So, I'll be right back, y'all. I got to go get this food.
they on their stuff. That's good.
They good. Fast, too.
Right? Bite this one and leave teethless. never sweat that, cause I'm a cool cat, just like Heathcliff. Beat this, give up the loot. It's 94 and bitch ass niggas, yeah, they still get the boot. The North Flakes, cause I be flowing in all states. Show kept digging and digging, now he got more crates. That's right, nigga, roll that dime, and I'm the only living matter that controls my mind. Peace to every single rapper on this whole earth. Sellouts got no worth, I think they better go soul search. Now here I go again, ready to flow again. And if the coast ain't clear, hell yeah, I'm still going in. Get it together or you'll be laying on a stretcher. I betcha, I'ma getcha, the number one heart stressor. Sorry, Black, that's right, it's a cardiac arrest. Try to triple team the best, then where's party at? Lost to knowing a warrior like Shogun. And when the show's done, stacks and stacks is how the hoes come. I boost your feeling, confidence is to the ceiling. If I'm sick, I'll pick a chick for sexual healings. I'm unique. A freak like Malik in the twilights with more highlights than Dominique. Around my boys is where the jail stops. Up to the streets, the jeeps, my peeps in the cell blocks. I'm not the best, but I give you stress. To flatter me, your strategy gotta be more complex than chess. Stop bluffing, cause you ain't saying nothing, G. And start ducking, I'm the A to the fucking G. Last LP, we got down right. Showed all these corny motherfuckers what hip hop's supposed to sound like. C-A-G and a brother show. Quiet is kept, it's best that you step on the low. Well, it's me, meaning the A to the dash. I'm fast to get the cash, now I'm going like the past. What's the remedy? Suckers better get their own identity into the enemy. You better roll like it's enemy. Fake lords, they get strangled with mic cords. Taking beats from my LP for sure ain't healthy. Patterson Projects is where I rest, but I claim the whole planet cause it's mine. God damn it, I'm God. Quick to pull a fake brother card. Wreck Boston, running shit in Portland like Bard. It's hard to face defeat when you're raised in the street. No surrender and no retreat. Now dance with the devil? No, not hardly. Even though I'm mamba like La Bamba and smoke ganja like Bob Marley. A bag of cess puts me at my rest. You say you're silly? That's my theory. Get the Philly and let it rest.
Shining the Bourbon Brothers every Monday right here at WNRV 108.1 for Conversation. 6 to 8 p.m. You never know what you're going to hear or what we're going to talk about, man. Tell a friend, tell a friend, tell their friends. Tap in.
The children of Israel, according to Genesis chapter 10, Egyptians descended from Ham. 600 years later, my brother read up. Moses was born in Egypt. In this era, black Egyptians weren't right. They enslaved black Israelites. Moses had to be of the black race because he spent 40 years in Pharaoh's place. He passed as the Pharaoh's grandson, so he had to look just like them. Yes, my brothers and sisters, take this here song. Yo, correct the wrong. The information we get today is just whack. But ask yourself, why is that?
I'm sorry. The government you have elected is inoperative.
The ignorant rapper is done. Knowledge reigns supreme over nearly everyone. The stereotype must be lost, that love and peace and knowledge is sore. Do away with that and understand one fact. For love, peace must attack. And attack real strong, stronger than war, to conquer it and its lore. Pictures, stereotypes, and fake history reinforces mystery. And when mystery is reinforced, that only means that knowledge has been lost. When you know who you really are, peace and knowledge shines like a star. I've only shown you a simple fact. It takes a nation of millions to hold us people back, which is whack, but we can correct that. Teach and learn what it is to be black, because they're teaching birds to be a cat. But ask yourself, homeboy, why is that?
The government.
This your boy MC Brains, chilling right here at WNRV 108.1.
This is WNRV
1 2 freak out on my shirt.
Well, can you rock it like this?
another swing. And if you mess with us, you'll be a real short liver. You may be big, but our bodyguard's bigger, 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 bigger. Can you rock it like this?
I can rock it like that.
Can you rock it like this?
I can rock it like that.
Can you rock it like this?
I can rock it like that.
Can you rock it like this?
Oh, but I rock it like that.
Just like the 80s, we back. We were talking about neighborhood stuff and initiatives and changes. No, I think it's like a seed program that I want to start to be able to get people in the community involved with things that they can realistically change and see. I think the problem why people don't believe in things is because they don't actually physically see the changes or the effects. Yeah.
And those things that, you know, jumping in those meetings and participating in those things and asking the right questions where you putting the right pressure in the right spots where you know you're going to see some changes.
Right. You're a constituent. You have rights. You're
and
they
being
work
consistent
for you.
About it.
Yeah, they work for you. You pay taxes, they work for you. You don't work for them. Yeah. You know, they work for you. So that's why they call it a public servant position, because they have to do what the public requires or requests them to do.
Yeah, right.
So if there's changes that need to be made, I mean, we have to start requesting the right changes. So if the street light's not working, request to have them street light repairs. If your neighborhood needs stuff that's going to make the neighborhood safe, if you got a kid with disabilities, like, demand those signages be put in the neighborhoods.
Right.
Because the moment you ride outside of your neighborhood into a suburb, you're going to know if it's a deaf kid on that block. You're going to know if it's a child with disabilities.
Signage and all that stuff is there.
Absolutely.
Right.
Their neighbor, you could bring just as much value to your neighborhood as they have in their neighborhoods. Mm-hmm. There's no such thing as, well, we don't have the money, we don't have the funding. If they tell you that, that's a lie.
Right.
That means that they're lining their pockets with those kickbacks.
What you need to ask is how you're allocating the money.
Absolutely.
You know?
I remember when we went to that cannabis thing and we talked to that congresswoman, and she basically said, like, you know, only reason they don't do nothing because y'all don't ask them to do nothing.
Right. You make their job easier.
Yeah.
Because you don't ask for anything, so they don't feel they have to do anything.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Why should they fight for you and you not telling them what you want?
Absolutely.
You
know? So, I mean, it's like, I think people get the wrong ideas about all the wrong things. So, you know,
that's
you
big.
You control the narrative as to, like, you know, don't celebrate when it's a beauty supply store or, you know, a hibachi restaurant or a dollar store in your neighborhood. That's not nothing to celebrate. Like, you should be worried because that's your money.
Yeah.
That money.
The neighborhood.
Yeah, they're giving this money to these foreigners to be in your neighborhood.
Yeah.
And all y'all doing is making them richer, because if you, that same idea that you had about making these clothes, just open your boutique, doing crocheting, doing hair, doing nails, that could be your spot. That could be you bringing value back to your community in your neighborhood.
The same way they came in, you can go and get the same money, the same low interest loan from the city, and do the same thing.
Yep.
But they don't know that. I guess
that's what we tell them.
Yeah, that's what we got to tell them.
And it's so funny, man, because.
And stay consistent, because it's a lot of hoops you got to jump through. You know,
you
I'm sure.
Have
but
your shit in order.
You got to have your shit
You
got to
be serious about it.
Yeah. Right.
Your checking account got to be, you can't have 1,000 overdraft fees.
Right. Yeah.
So I only had $9.99, so I made.
Oh, so you made it.
that one.
The 1 percentile.
Yeah.
So yeah, so that's.
Yeah, you gotta have it right.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, that's big.
Anybody need the link to the list? Hit me up.
Yeah. This is free information, man. It's free 99.
Yeah,
for sure.
This is free 99. You know this.
I share because somebody shared with me.
Absolutely, and this affects the babies as well.
Yeah.
So I mean, you know, in the morning when your kids out there, they got to get on those school buses because y'all sending y'all kids way out the way to schools that they shouldn't be going to anyway. Like your neighborhood, it has the same resources and value to bring those things back to your community.
And you have the voice to change that.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So instead of walking through the playground talking about, you know, what they're not doing,
walk through the playground and show what they should be doing and make it known at those council meetings with that same footage.
Exactly.
You know, showing people on Instagram and TikTok is not effective. You have to show that shit in the boardroom and the council meetings of the ward that you live in, because there's funding allocated specifically for rebuilding those projects.
Don't just befriend your favorite DJ.
Right.
Befriend your councilman, councilwoman.
Right.
Yeah. That's right. I say, they work for you.
They know where it's coming from.
Right.
They work for you.
Yeah. That's big.
It's all facts, man. So, what else? Oh, so I want to talk about reality TV and the detachment from reality.
We changing gears?
Yeah, we changing gears.
On that note,
we changing gears.
So I think it's funny, man, that we have become such a distracted society.
Can you switch your other hand and pass that?
But it's not even a productive society. It's just a distracted society. The bourbon.
The alcohol.
The bourbon.
Why are you playing?
Yeah. She gave everything but.
So if everything that you want to teach your children to be is on TV, what is the value that you're instilling in your children?
Say it one more time now.
If everything that you want your children to be is on TV, what values are you instilling in your children?
Aha.
The problem is.
Speak on the mic.
This is DJ Squirt, regional VP of the Nerve DJs.
Oh, Lord.
you just couldn't help yourself. Right.
I had to say that. So the problem is the parents aren't educated. They don't have the guidance and the resources and the habits instilled in them to resource and research and the consciousness to understand the value in a child's mind.
Do you think that's the truth?
I do. I do.
That's a cop-out to a certain degree.
It's not a cop-out.
No, it's not a cop-out. It's a false narrative. And I'll tell you why after she finished talking.
I'm going to tell you why before you start.
Okay.
No, we
want to
hear.
Please do. I want to finish out. Finish out.
What I'm saying is you have these children in homes that have, you know, they're walking around from the ages of 0 to 5. Mm-hmm. And all they're being taught, guns, weed, gossip, lying. They see their mama lie to their mama. They see their mama lie to other people. They see their mama undermine, mm-hmm. blah, blah, blah. So they learn that same behavior. Look at them playing Sexy Red, 2-year-olds with microphones having a party, talking about shake that ass, hoe.
That's all through media. That's all through media.
And that's true, exactly. Right. So if those parents are teaching that to their kids, at a certain age, you got to know. You got
to
know.
But that's the parent copping out to, this is the easy way out, and I'm not spending time with my child and developing a relationship and letting the media teach that child.
It's learned behavior.
Yeah, from mm-hmm. something from not the parent. It's not coming from the parent. It's coming from the media.
But
because
it's in the house. I had it too.
But if you
were
a parent, you had the ability to control that and turn it off.
And they don't.
Or do other stuff.
And
that's a cop out. That's where I'm going
with
that.
It's still the parent's responsibility, regardless what the media is showing.
Okay. So
what you got to say?
So what I'm going to say is it's a false narrative, and I'll say why. Because it's not that the parents don't teach their kids or don't know. They're limited with what they learn. So you got to remember that we came up in the era of the 90s and the 2000s.
Different age.
We know what we were dealing with in that era. So the parents of these kids are the parents of the ecstasy pills, of wet. This is the beginning of the ADHD generation. Mm-hmm. And instead of them changing that narrative to, you know, what the man in the white coat told them, they mm-hmm. adopted and embraced it and used it as a crutch to try to succeed to society. This is why you have more poor customer service and treatment and facilities than you've ever seen in your lifetime. So it's a spiral effect. So what they have now is digital daycare. Digital daycare is you giving your kids 100% of YouTube or apps to entertain them while you scroll on your phone. So the parents, it's not the fault that they're teaching their kids, because no parent is teaching their kids Sexy Red. These are the things that they're being exposed to on the internet, because there's so much things being over-sexualized. There's so much violence being over-glorified. So these are the things that, you know, the older brothers and the older sisters are teaching the younger children. This is why you have to grab them now. So that generation gap of the drug-affected people that are here now as mm-hmm. adults, they're phasing over into another part of reality that they're not even going to make it through. Because they've already set the boundary as far as they can go. Out of 95% of them, only 5% really want to change their life. The rest of them are okay with a Saturday night lifestyle Monday through Friday. This is why there's no growth. This is why there's no change. This is why.
Is that almost settle into a certain degree?
I would love to add to this, and I'm going to speak from experience.
Go ahead.
Okay, this is not just about the drugs or whatever in the parent. We have more children. If I am 53 years old and I was banned and left on the street corner at five and grew up in the system, more than 70 to 80% of the adults now that are 40 and 50 actually grew up in the system.
But that was during a different time.
Hold on. Let me.
Go ahead.
I like fighting.
I just want to stay on. I just want to stay on point.
One day we're going to put a ring in here with some Jell-O. We're going to go at it.
You're going to be the only one sliding around.
Anyway. You know, I just land. Okay. But anyway, what I want to say is because of my own experience of how I was educated. And when you change the whole narrative of actually being a parent and caring about a child, now you have a foster or a judicial system, kind of just like a prison, moving you around, not with that same nourishment, knowledge, brush your teeth, wash your hair, clean your skin. They don't say nothing to you because they're getting paid to have you. They're just moving you around and letting the time go. So you got a lot of people in that condition is what I'm trying to say to you.
I get that, but the
story. So it's not even their parents.
No, but the story is the same because you have children who live with their parents that still don't get that same narrative.
Same difference, but number one, you got them that are educated, learning. You got people teaching them. They got them to church.
But we're not talking about them.
And then they go to school. Hold on. Then they go to school. And they meet with the other 80% of the kids that wasn't taught that. So they're thinking that what their parents taught them was wrong because these kids do whatever the hell they want to do. Why? Come on now.
But this is why you have the difference between educated children and digital daycare children. Digital daycare children are of influence because they think that that's the narrative. So the kids that don't have any self-esteem, those are the kids that they gravitate to. Meanwhile, the kids that are individuals because their parents or their family members pour into them, they see the other side of that and they choose not to participate.
Exactly.
This is where individualism comes in. So that's, again, that's that 5%. Because the narrative that every parent and every person of positive influence should teach their kids is never dumb, never cool to be stupid. It's never cool to be stupid.
And you're right. So that's why we need to do this.
Right. But this is what I'm saying. The whole narrative is you have to want to participate in the changing of the narrative.
Yes.
So that goes from businesses to medical. Like, you have to have accountability in everything that's failing the people in the public.
Exactly.
And everything out here now is failing the people in the public, from nursing homes to fast food restaurants to grocery stores. Anything that has to do with a customer service base is failing society right now.
Yeah.
Because they're not employing quality employees. They're employing bodies to add numbers to shifts that are being absent. So what COVID did, like I said, it was a gift and a curse. But now we're living through the curse because the world is back open, but we're not getting quality, we're getting quantity. So you're getting a large amount of people that think that it's a bag we're coming putting on those scrubs. And the bag season is over because there's no more traveling nurses, there's no more pandemic, shutting it down, that money is dry. So you actually got to do your job now. So now this is where your value system comes in. But you don't have any values because you don't want to wipe ass. You don't want to go over there and turn that lady over. You don't want to deal with the woman with dementia. You don't want to do that. So that's where the abuse and the neglect comes in. But all that stems from the companies being accountable for the people that they hire. You pay these people to be there. They're not there because they love these people. They're there because you pay them to be there. Yeah, right. So in a sense, you're contributing to the abuse and the neglect of the people that's paying to be there. Their medical insurance pays for them to have a bed there. Their family pays for them to have a bed there. Along with those beds that they have there should come a level of comfort. They're not receiving that. You know what they're receiving? The chick that got drunk at happy hour that showed up in scrubs that now she don't want to go in there and turn the lady over so she don't get bed sores. So they save it to the next shift to come in, and now you got bed sores.
Understood. So look, that also contributes to the people that are running this community. And the people that are running this community are the same children that were abandoned, left in group home systems, whatever. They sent them to the military and then trying to make them civil after they spent 18 years in the streets you know what I'm saying? No mannerism, no support, no help. You have to want. So that's where the things in the community, us as businesses, come into play, right? We got all these damaged people, but if they have some type of refuge, like myself, you know, like music, you know, somebody just care. Sometimes all you need is a good-ass conversation. Right?
Yeah.
I disagree.
And I'm he's smacking my first.
Watch yourself.
You know
I'm not
tag teaming me up in here.
I'm not disagreeing because of what you're saying is wrong. I'm disagreeing on the level of narratives. Like, what worked for you, that's not everybody's situation or circumstance.
I wasn't saying that.
No, but I'm saying you said they have all these people that did X, Y, and Z.
That's fine. I'm not disregarding those people at all. It's like the homeless situation. Everybody out there is not homeless by force. Some of them homeless by choice.
True. And
so, but we can't lump all those people into the problem itself.
Okay. Let me break this down because you're getting it wrong. I'm not saying everybody had it like me.
I didn't say that. See, this is what I'm saying. This is part of the disconnect in society that I talk about.
Okay.
We try to have an open platform of a conversation to be able to say, okay, well, we can agree to disagree, or this is the problem that we agree that this is the problem that we're trying to fix.
Gotcha.
And we don't want to dissect the conversation to pertain it to what benefits us or what victimizes us.
True.
And I think that's what a lot of people do now. They don't hear the whole thing to try to, you know, find a common ground to solve the problem.
Mm-hmm.
They rather find fault or blame in it to say that
right.
This is me, this is why I'm a victim of this. No, it's bigger than you. It's bigger. Not.
Exactly.
It's not about you in no regard. It's not about me in any regard.
Exactly.
There is just a problem that we see that needs to be resolved
right.
within the community. And these are the things that we should pay attention to as a community. So if somebody else can go out and get the information and bring it back to the community,
true.
The community has to use that information to fix the problem. You have people who want to fix the problem in places where they don't live because they know that these people are being shortchanged. But if no one cares enough, or maybe they just don't know mm-hmm. enough, there you should be thankful that you have people out there with the access that's going to get the information and saying, come on, y'all, if we pull our resources together, we could be just as much, if not more valuable than our competitors, because our competitors, they live comfortably. They get everything that's given to them, and all they got to do is say, hey, Officer Timpson, we're on the corner, and our corner needs a stop sign. Next week, it's a stop sign on that corner.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we can go down there and say, hey, Officer Jones, you should put a stop sign on the corner. Well, you got to go complain to somebody because that ain't my problem. And that's what we get.
I get it.
That's what we get.
I get where you at.
Right. So now, you know what I'm saying? Somebody got to say, man, how can I get a stop sign put on this corner in my neighborhood? And then somebody like, you know what? You right. It should be a stop sign on that
mm-hmm.
corner of the neighborhood. You don't know? Let me go find out the answer. You talk to the people locally. I'll go talk
that's
to
the
people
problem.
Legislatively, and we're gonna meet a common
together.
Ground. Right. That's what we gotta fix.
Exactly.
That's the problem.
And we finally
that's what
agree.
I'm saying.
I love you.
You
look,
better love me. I'm trying to tell you.
I agree with you.
Why was his name Officer Tempkin?
But look, this takes it back. Now, this takes it back to
why was his name Officer
Tempkin?
I'm sorry.
Okay, I'm just giving my perspective. I can't speak on nobody else. That's why it is what it is.
Yeah.
You're not the interviewer today. We're not interviewing you, Squirt.
It's not an interview.
It ain't about you, Squirt. It's about the community.
I'm talking about the community. Look, so I'm just telling you what I see. I can only speak on what I see.
Tell me what you see.
This is what I see. Exactly what you were saying, how in our communities, why the people in the community do not, you know, come together to do whatever. These are the same people in our community that was left or messed up or mentally abused, and then they get a certain age and expect to be civil. No, we gotta get together.
I come from
mentally.
A community. I wasn't none of that.
You weren't.
Right. So
some
I'm saying
are.
that narrative don't fit
it's
everybody.
It's not just the community. I'm just
it's
saying.
About, but I'm saying, I'm talking about community scale as a whole.
Okay.
The damage, the victims. The misplaced,
the
unfortunate,
but a lot
everything.
Of these people are holding these positions in these offices is what
but,
I'm trying to say.
But who's in the community going to find out
exactly.
how to challenge these people in office?
We need to.
Right. That's the narrative I'm delivering.
Oh, I totally agree.
Yeah, that's the narrative I'm delivering.
I totally agree.
Yeah, so I want to be the messenger that be able to say, hey, this is what you got to do in order to go talk to them.
Okay.
This is the segue
put
of joint tying the laces.
The
like, yeah, we got to tie the laces to be able to fix this.
Bring people together.
Damn, that's what I'm saying.
That's what I love. I'm with it. But it's hard to be rational. It's hard to be rational
How about
with
that?
Others that are not
It's
rational.
Hard to be rational when somebody got a cell phone trying to be like, hey.
I just want
to
make sure you look pretty.
I don't.
You're the only one concerned about that.
Right.
I am.
Hold me.
I don't ever want to be pretty.
What's up,
okay, I don't ever want to be pretty.
I have a hard time in here with them, but I love it. I love it. Nope, I agree with you. And anytime you would like me to march with you or show up in that councilman's office, I'm with you.
Well, I mean, we already doing it.
I just want everybody to see what you're saying. See, you're talking about sharing it with the people. Now
I am sharing. This is information.
Oh,
I've been passing the information since I've been on the air.
Don't feel slighted because, you know, you're getting in a little late.
Yeah,
but it's okay, though, because you're on the same.
Late.
See, late. I got to fight you.
Late.
You love me.
She had a plan B, y'all. She late.
I love you, too, but you still getting in late.
I have a hard time with them, y'all. I'm about to get off. This ain't even my show, and I done bum rushed the show, so they mad at me.
We ain't mad at you.
I'm just talking trash.
It's great conversation.
Yeah, she's a content creator.
Yeah, Yes. She's so part now of everybody's going to watch it because they think
she's part of the digital
world.
Digital, she's part of the digital, digital daycare people.
No.
I said digital world. I ain't going to call her daycare, but, you know, digital world.
I'm going to say it. No, because I think a lot of people misunderstand what I'm saying.
I
think
did,
that
gets which is like, cool. That's why I did
yeah,
that.
But like Prince said it a long time ago. Like they created a way to distract you and steal your soul at the same time.
He did.
And
he
it was
did.
Called the internet. Mm-hmm. And look at now, like people don't even call people for help in dire situations anymore.
That's
they
real.
Take out their phone and record.
Yeah.
Like you could see an elderly woman get hit by a car and knocked on the curb. The car keep going.
The first
they won't pick up their phone and call 911.
They'll
turn that camera on.
Yeah. The license plate off.
Imagine that.
This is the world we live in. Like we've normalized becoming desensitized. Mm-hmm. That's a
wow.
scary place to live.
That is. Mm-hmm.
That is a scary place to live when you could watch families being slaughtered over in Egypt mm-hmm. because they won't give up an area.
They think it's entertaining.
Yeah, they be like, this is what's going on. And you would turn on the radio in the morning, listen to these talk shows, and they glorify, oh man, they were slaughtering women and children
isn't
and gunning
sad?
Them down. And like, yeah. this is nothing to be excited yeah, about for ratings
and
or
you've
media.
You've recorded it on your cell phone.
Exactly. Like,
yeah,
no.
you
got to. They should start making them go to jail for recording it.
Yeah. But you got to ask yourself, like, what type of sick individual am I to find entertainment in this?
I don't.
You're sick. If you find entertainment in somebody else's misfortune, something wrong with you. Mm-hmm. Whether you've been misled or distracted so much to the mm-hmm. point that you become desensitized by what's being publicized,
people are programmed
like
that
that's, but you should learn how to reprogram yourself. True. Like everything, like.
And dare you call it a new norm, you know, but that's still a sickness.
But what's
that's
the value? Oh, I ask people all the time, what's your value? Personally, people should ask themselves all the time, where is my value? Where do my values lie? What am I worth?
Until something bad happens to them.
To them. Right, to them.
Until something yeah. bad happens right. to them, does things click.
And that's sad.
And they'll be 40 years old doing the same thing what they
sure.
saw when they was two.
Yeah.
And that's real.
This is a very scary place to be in life right now.
It is.
This is a very scary place to be in life right now. And I think that, you know, unless you know how to think or you know how to look at things from multiple perspectives, you're going to miss out or you're going to get caught up.
Yeah.
I will say this, though. I think the pandemic also did do a great shift in a lot of people's mentality, because a lot of people that I did know that were, like, just wilding out, certain things happened to them. Then
look
they snap out of it. Now they're moving forward.
Did they
in
hit
a
rock
direction.
Bottom?
Exactly. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
In a positive direction. So, you know.
Well, that number is, like, minimal as shit.
I believe it is, but
the
I'm
rest
saying,
of these folks
here.
Is batshit crazy out here.
Like, for example, even the music, you know, like I collect a lot of music from the independent artists, mm-hmm. even the music is changing. It's turning more
really?
Positive. I'm going to say I received 300 or 400 songs in the last 4 months, and I'll say 75% of them are more heartfelt
okay.
changing than I used to get.
Mm.
Okay.
Well,
I pay attention to that.
The
I'm
emails I get are the polar
meet.
Opposite.
Well,
I got more ass shaking, booty clapping, and gun shooting than you could use in a whole decade.
It's not all gone all the way. I'm just saying.
No, I mean,
I
don't.
What do you got? Booty shaking, ass clapping. You just ripped that off like it wasn't nothing.
Yeah, I can't even repeat that if you paid me.
No, but seriously.
Right.
I'm 75% of the music. That's a big change.
That's a huge change.
The last 4 or 5 months out of last year, before January, they were all, fuck this nigga, shoot him up.
Right,
I don't give a fuck. You know, now, you know, it was all Sexy Red stuff and it was all, you know, kill him, drug, popping pills.
That's Sexy
right.
Red. So that,
now,
we knew that was going to die
they're
for
being
fade
more
quick.
Conscious, and that's, I'm being speaking honestly. So
okay.
since January, what, January, February, March? That's 3 months.
3 months in, right.
I've gotten at least 335 tracks because I tell them they can send it to me free on purpose because they want you. And I listen because I want to know what people
okay.
are thinking.
Okay.
And I swear 75% of those tracks, they're all conscious.
The narrative has changed.
Yeah.
Right,
the narrative is backing off from the violence. Is, you know, so it's what I'm saying is things have shifted.
I'm just going to say shout out to Cesar Rio because his music always got
a
message. Shout out to HJS because he's part of that, you know, hip hop
mm-hmm.
community. Shout out to Richie Carlisle,
mm-hmm.
you know, because he's different with his style of flow.
He's
I mean,
very different.
Yeah, I you know, it's a lot of artists out there that I could say their names and because they're different.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I also have, you know, the other side of the spectrum too. And You know, I believe in giving everybody their flowers, regardless of where your talent lies. If you're talented enough and you got enough confidence in yourself to get out there and you know, demand your presence, you know, I got a place for you. So there's a new show coming on Fridays. It's a one-hour show in the evenings. It's 100% independent artists and exclusive music.
You said evenings. Also,
yeah, Friday
nine,
evenings.
10 o'clock somewhere in there?
Like 8, 9.
Okay,
somewhere
all right. Okay,
like that.
All right,
cool. Yeah, it's 100%.
You need a host?
No. Because it's more mixing than
it's covered.
Else.
It's covered. it's covered.
not to be so quick with it, but.
I know, just shut me right off.
You asked, you got to answer. Move
Thank
on.
You. Thank you so much. Okay.
Occasionally, because.
<I'm crazy. laughs> Yeah, he just mopped the floor with me.
The janitor.
The janitor. Not janitor, janitor.
The janitor.
That was funny.
But really, it is changing, and I noticed that also. So mm-hmm. That's kind of a good thing. You got to kind of rock with the good stuff, and you know.
So let me ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
So my question to you is.
Don't get excited. Slow down.
Yeah,
slow down,
no.
Slow down.
So my question to you is, being in a position that you are and dealing with a lot of independent artists, mm-hmm. and you saying that the music narratives is starting to change upon what you're receiving. Mm-hmm. So how do you deal with that or manage that, being in your position to choose a side without being biased?
Because you got to put yourself in that person's position that's making the song. That's why I like to do a lot of interviews, to get to know where they're coming from. And when you learn that person, then you can kind of more understand maybe why they came up with that. I never tell someone, ooh, that was terrible, even if it was terrible. In my opinion, I just listen to it and try to add to the quality that they were adding to it, or offer information that I know that could make it better,
mm-hmm.
get opinions, and then ask other people to chime in, and I go from there.
So what about when the majority starts to overrule the minority? So if you start to get more conscious music in versus more trap music, and the conscious crowd is checking in with you, but you still have to, you know, appease
both
the other crowd, the other side. So how do you balance that out to make it make sense to these people so you don't lose their audience?
That's if it's, if the music sound good, though,
exactly.
Right?
No, it's not. It's no. She just said that if it don't sound bad, you still have to be able to be professional, which I get. Mm-hmm. That's a good answer.
I just figured like in the critique, but I'm just saying like far as pushing it, it still have to be good music though, right?
No, I'm saying what happens?
To be free.
Like she said, the music, the narrative is
changing. No, I'm talking about playing and getting it out.
No, she said the narrative is changing with the music that she's receiving.
Right.
So I'm asking her, as a host, for what she do. What happens when one genre of music supersedes the other genre? How do you keep it balanced? Like without choosing sides, but you've gained more from a side that was never really your audience.
I just go with whatever comes to me. I can't do that. I don't think I have a say-so in that. If that other genre doesn't send it to me,
okay,
and only one does, yeah, I'm gonna rock with that.
Okay, that's the answer I was looking for.
Mm-hmm. You represent
what's in front
of you. I'm not
going to sit
there
and say, yeah, I want rock music. No, whatever they send me, we're going to rock with it.
Okay. And whatever the majority is ruling, then that's what's going to get
the... That's
what it is. Okay.
But luckily, it's a large variety. You know,
okay.
Have you had... the country and everything, so...
Have you had an artist... Have you seen them switch?
Mm-hmm. Oh, my God.
And has their fan base switched with them?
I don't know that part.
Okay.
I don't know that answer.
That's... Okay.
There's so many independent artists that are awesome, which is why I started the program that I'm going to be doing. Because if they follow the steps, regardless, it's going to get out there.
So what's your end goal with this?
The end goal is to show them how to run it and be productive financially,
mm-hmm.
and business savvy, sustain it.
Mm-hmm.
Because if they do that and they follow those steps the same way these labels are doing them, they claim they ball and they go, okay, this, I got this, and this, what you want to do? You're not paying me. You're going to take the steps. Then as you keep moving, then they only naturally will build other supporters, other people, other information outside of me.
Mm-hmm.
So if you show them how to start moving, then they move.
Okay.
I'm telling you, there's so many. There's this group, and one's in Maryland, one's in New York, and they're called Eat One, something like that. Mm. Eat Ones.
They do music, or it's like a...
They do music.
Okay. All
right. And what this guy did is, because I used to tell everybody, take the top 10 genres, take top 10 songs from each genre, the top 10, put them in a playlist, listen to them, and use your creativity to create the styles out of everything you're hearing.
Mm-hmm.
Day Ones Eat, that's the name of their group. They came back to me. They, when I go Music Live sometimes, they had a country song, they had a reggae, they had a Latin, they had different, and they all are dope. Every last track they submitted is dope.
Interesting.
So building that relationship, they continue to send me these songs so that I'm building a catalog myself, what I'm doing. So for example, I don't know, let's say you're a super producer and you have a show. It's like, Squirt, you know what, I need, you know, an artist that's willing
you
to go, boom, boom, boom.
To get that.
But since they've been working with me, I know, okay, they gonna travel, they gonna hit it, and then I'm gonna work, what you gonna, well, if they come, I'm gonna pay them this. They gotta bring this, that, and the other and be here on time. And I transfer the information and send them on their way. Boom, that's a connect. You get what you need, they're getting what they want.
So how do you feel about artists that want all, they want promotion and marketing off of your clout, but don't want to, but don't have, I'm not going to say don't want to spend the money, but don't see the value in spending their money with you, but they'll spend it with your competitors.
They can still take the services of the free submission. And if I like or feel like doing it on a $5 holiday, then that's cool. That's not going to stop me from doing what I do. That's their choice.
No, but I'm asking you. So
they don't spend their money with me.
Yeah, they don't spend their money with you, but they expect to see, they expect you to promote their product. Like they'll send you their product and they'll say, hey Squirt, you know we fuck with you, blah 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 blah. And then, you know, even though you know they ain't breaking bread with you, but they still want, you know, break bread promotion.
I still will do it. If they take the opportunity to take advancement in what I have for free, mm-hmm. when I'm doing it, I do it.
Message.
Wow.
That's nothing to do with me
shit,
because
that's
I got
shit.
My own plan.
That's good shit.
I got my own plan.
But it's a misconception, I think, between radio and DJs and independent artists. I think independent artists feel like because they send you their music that you're obligated to give something to them. And
true.
It's not the case where you actually run a whole business. So everything that you do costs money. So they don't see the value in spending their money with mm-hmm. you. But they see the value in spending that same money that they won't give you with a company that's just going to take your money and send you back home with an attaboy or a thank you.
But they won't tag them in their damn post, but they want to tag me.
That's it.
Nah.
Yeah.
I don't care if you spend $5 with me. I don't owe you nothing after you spent that $5. Give you that shout out. I don't owe you nothing the next day.
But it's crazy that you only requested $5.
Exactly.
These people request thousands of dollars. And you run to spend thousands of dollars with these people because they sit in a different platform mm-hmm. where they still have to come back and talk to us to get notoriety or validity mm-hmm. for you.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the whole thing. Like,
ain't that crazy?
Yeah, people want free validation.
They won't do nothing. If they was in that position, they won't do it for you.
They want free validation.
Like they're owed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This. Yeah.
Well, you know, I've been rocking with you for 20 years, man. And, you know, you the homie. So I just know that you going to open the gate for me to come through. It's like, wait.
Yeah. Hold on.
Whoa.
Or they say,
I've been rocking with you for 20 years, but what about the work I put in for 20 years?
Yeah, you've been following 20 years. Yeah.
Don't say no name.
Yeah.
But it was like, I do, and I thought, I know, and I rock with, so you should have, you did it that way, so I did it that way.
Yeah.
You can't tell me how to do it my way if you did it your way.
When people say I'd be like, well,
so
you.
They say I, you're good.
You, yeah. You don't need me. You got it all. You got it all figured out.
That's big.
There's nothing for me to talk to you about.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so when I offer or do something that I'm doing for free, number one, I do this because I love it. Like, I don't know how to be still. I just don't. So when I'm working my plan and my business and what I'm doing, and I decide to have a $5 holler, whoever sent it on that list, we going for it.
Okay.
Because I put it this way. It's about your energy, and you're only as good as your intentions.
Mm-hmm.
My intentions are to help you.
Flat out.
If I help and I put you on my platform, regardless what it does for you, I'm doing my due diligence. Now, how
what
you
said you
were going to
do
move with
from
it,
onset,
that's
right,
on
right.
you.
Absolutely.
But usually what happens is they have a good time. They love it. I got $5. I got an interview. I got exposed. She playing my song. Sometimes I just go in there and make a flyer and put their song on it and play and put it out. And they ain't even ask me. They're like, oh, my God, thank you. It's about how you make people feel.
That's the part that I think that people miss. It's like even when you do the mix shows for people, mm-hmm. like they send this music in. You put together a mix show with these independent artists' music only. Mm-hmm. You might have one or two exclusives in there that's not out released yet. But 90% of the show is independent artists.
Mm-hmm.
So you put this mix together without informing them, without letting them know. They ain't got to tune in. They be like, oh, I sent you my song. I'm like, well, did you listen to the mix show from last week? Nope. So if you don't even follow me enough or pay attention enough to what I do respectfully with independent artist music to see if you were even in the mix.
Like, if you send me something that I tell you is dope and I put it in the mix, like, at least make sure you tell me you heard the mix.
No, they don't do that.
Yeah, so if you ain't hear the mix, I feel like, why should I recycle your record again another week? Like, if you find a song that, like, I don't give a damn. If your song is fire, like, I hear a bunch of fire-ass shit, and I'll play they shit out in the street. I'll play they shit on mix shows because I do what the fuck I want to do. Like, I don't.
But
I, don't,
that, I get that where you're coming from.
Yeah,
you
I know, do what the fuck I want to do. Like, if I like your shit, like, you're not going to tell me I can't play it.
Exactly.
Like, somebody be like, hey, man, this is exclusive. Don't play it yet. Fuck that. I'm going to play this shit.
Why would you send it out?
Yeah, like, you send it to me, I'm a hard
You shouldn't put it in my hands.
I'm going to play
you
your shit. Right. Like, unless you got something super exclusive, then they'd be like, all right, I fuck with you. I'll respect your wishes. But, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you send me something that's fire and I just see an opportunity that you don't see or you don't have access to, I'm playing your fucking record. I'm doing you a favor without even you knowing I'm doing you a favor.
People got a problem with control, too.
Oh, I don't have a problem because I can't
be
controlled.
You, I'm saying.
No, I'm just saying. But artists will say that. Well, I sent you that in, you know, in confidence, nigga. I don't give a fuck.
What's confidence in music?
Right. It's music. I play what the fuck I want to play. I do what I want to do.
Never heard that.
It's my way. Ooh. I'm the DJ. Mm-hmm. You're the rapper.
Ooh. That was some real shit you just said, though.
Yeah.
I'm a real
But that's I like
queen.
That though. Yeah.
It's real shit.
Right. Right.
But look, another thing is, you know, like people do, they're like, I did this, I don't say nothing. See, I got my own plan.
Mm-hmm.
And I organize my stuff. So let me tell you what I've been doing $5 hollers since 2018 and it's been $5.
Mm-hmm.
I end up with $200 sometime a night online.
Just
$5 hollers.
Yeah, right.
Because they know what I'm gonna do. They know who
right,
I am
right.
And they care.
Yeah.
Guess who hits me up all the time to know when I'm gonna get online? PRs, managers.
Cause they listening for that next. They want to hear that next sound.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah.
They want to hear that next sound.
So it ain't about the artist.
But the sad part about it is, I think artists' ego dictates their future or their demise, mm-hmm. because their ego gets in the way of their talent because they listen to people that is not doing shit. Mm-hmm. So if you listen to all your homies that standing there telling you the shit. Mm-hmm. But they now one of them sat in the boardroom or at a meeting or on an online conference call and they don't know what the trend is or mm-hmm. upcoming trend is because believe it or not, there are seasons to music that come out.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever the trend is or whatever the A&Rs think that's hot, they'll tell you like, well, this is the sound that we're kind of thinking that's going to take over the summer. Mm-hmm. Unless you got a bulletproof product that's going to be like, no, this going to be the sound that the streets going to be fucking with.
Mm-hmm.
And they look for that. And if you don't know that, there's no way in hell you can sit back with your cronies and tell me, you know what I'm saying, firsthand from sitting here at the table, what you think is this mm-hmm. and that and the third. It's like, when y'all start talking crazy like that, I just be like, okay, well, you got it, homie.
Right,
see,
right.
You got it.
The thing, too, is people think they can befriend you.
And steal your connects.
And you're going to do everything
and,
for
and
them.
Yeah,
you're
yep.
going to
yeah, yeah.
give them.
That agenda-driven shit.
Nope.
Oh. Yeah. As if you're
do,
not going to see it. And like, as if you're not going to see it.
Right.
Because that's what I do. Anybody
right,
that knows
right.
me, I've been doing the same stuff, period. It's not, I'm not doing nothing totally extra, but that's how I can benefit you.
But they got to mm-hmm. check your resume.
But they don't.
No.
They just think, okay, I saw her on a picture with, you know.
You know how they, this
that
what
person,
this what
she
they think.
Get me to that person, but they don't know I really know that person.
Yeah, and here's the young, this is the young mind. Right, this right, is the right. ignorance of, and I'm giving you credit by saying ignorance because it's really stupidity.
Mm-hmm.
Because you know better, but you still choose to do dumb shit.
That's stupidity.
Yeah, so that's stupidity. But I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt and say this is your ignorance right
mm-hmm.
here. Everybody that's on my friends list or on social media is not my professional friends. We don't follow the people in the business on our social media pages, especially that's not private. For people
yeah.
like y'all to go through and be like, oh, right. man, he knows right. such and such them. Oh, so I'm going to just go follow them, and I'm going to send him my music, and I'm going to tell him that I sent my music to him, and then he sent the music to them, and then I'm going to be in. And then, you know, they get a interview from somebody's show that they had to pay to be on.
Exactly.
And then this shit goes nowhere. It's a five-minute conversation. They still never meet the person that they were in, that they wanted to meet.
I got a story. I'm not going to tell no names.
Go ahead. I'm sure.
I ain't gonna tell them the names, but this person, you know, when I was in Atlanta, they were like, oh my God, I'll be seeing you in K-Camp, you in bigger ranking, and oh my God, you having this splash tour, I'm coming, come on through. We had a good time. While, you know, when people hit the city like that, you gotta hit your rounds to
mm-hmm.
spend your money to be there, go to interviews, go do. Introducing them to a couple A&Rs that happened to be there, a couple TV people was at K-Camps, and set up a meeting. Actually, I communicated with somebody big and said, hey, I got these people from here. Hey, bring them with you. Come, you know, promote your splash tour.
Do what you do. Right,
just bring
right.
them with you since they came to be on it with you. Okay, cool. I tell them, hey, we going
this
here.
This is what we're doing.
I got y'all. You're going to get a freebie today.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Big freebie. The big freebie had moved. So you know how Atlanta is. I didn't have that address.
Mm-hmm.
But the big freebie said, okay, I got you. I'm going to send you the address. You know, you got to mm-hmm. wait on the
right,
admin
right.
or whoever to send you the actual address. Boom. Well, the admin
that
sent the address to the other person.
Mm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
The other person.
I know where this is going.
Never told me.
Yeah.
And shot out there to the interview
yeah.
without me. Didn't say nothing to me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
we all hanging around. It's like 10 of us. We all hanging around
right,
waiting.
Right. Gone.
That person darted off, went by themselves. And then that person said, where's Squirt at?
Where's everybody else at?
Mm-hmm.
Right, right.
Where's Squirt at? He knew it was about 10 people.
Because right,
it was pushing all of us up there.
Yeah,
right.
Right.
Oh, I thought I told her.
Get out of here.
Get out of here. Yep. Exactly.
Beat it.
Called me up while they standing there. Don't know. I know
yeah,
him.
Yeah,
just
right.
because I talked to the admin don't mean I know. Don't know them.
Right.
right
that
right.
person called me right there. What's going on?
This where
baby?
I'm at.
What's up? What happened? I'm waiting on you. I never got the address. You didn't. Oh, okay. Get out of here.
Yep. Door closed.
You cannot go stepping on people's
no.
necks.
You never know.
To get ahead, because they just push you backwards.
Yeah.
Because now them people ain't gonna mess with them.
Yeah. They don't understand that. I've been preaching that. For the last, I think that was part of the main narrative for Independent Artist Spotlight since 2019. And it was just like, you know what? I keep trying to tell y'all, like, y'all can't finesse me. The finesse game, like, yeah, we invented that shit.
Yeah.
Like, y'all don't understand. If y'all ain't never heard of, what's the company that used to be in business with the MCI? if y'all ain't had an MCI Chrome
right.
cars back in the day, that's where the finesse game started. So
yeah.
you know, y'all trying to rerun shit that we already wrote the rules to. You understand?
And down that street,
you yeah, can't. Right. You can't. It's impossible because niggas be like, well, just because you don't hear our names in the clubs and shit like that, don't mean
okay.
that we're not
nope.
working.
Yes,
I like the people that's not in the clubs. Actually.
Yeah, it's levels
right.
to life, mm-hmm. man. You know, if you grew up playing in the playground, you don't become a teenager still ride the merry-go-round.
Right.
You just don't. You don't become a 20-year-old and still jump down there on the thing, the damn horse that goes back and forth. You just don't.
You some just don't do that.
Yeah,
huh?
You outgrow some things. You know what I mean?
So it's an adult.
Yeah, so it's like you have different levels
That's
of conversation
funny.
As you elevate
right,
through
right.
life.
That's true.
But if you're not having those conversations or elevating through life, and if I'm in the same place today that I was 30 years ago,
ooh-wee.
I ain't did a goddamn thing yeah. productive with my life.
Yeah.
I can't change shit for nobody because I'm fucked up.
Yeah.
So, you know, for you to still think like, you know, well, I remember when they used to be this, that, and the third,
the
but you can't tell me about me now. You can only tell me about something that was 20 years ago, and
exactly.
those places don't even exist no more. Mm-hmm. So it's like, that, you really don't know me.
Mm-hmm.
You really don't know me. You don't know what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. But they were like, well, I was talking to such and such, and your name came up. I'm like, that's good. I mean, well, how is that going to benefit you?
Right.
That's the question you should be asking. Yeah, my name came up. What you going? Oh, I know. They're going to say, when last time you talked to him? Oh man, it's been some time. But, you know, I remember back in the day, we used to, the conversation with them is dead. Like, they done already cut you off. They done tuned you out.
Mm-hmm.
They're like, oh, you don't know that, man. I see this man all the time. I talk to this man every day.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know this man. You looking for an opportunity. But instead of you going through him that can open the door for him, you trying to go around him.
Yeah.
And if you're going to go around him and he's a direct connect or acquaintance of ours, then we definitely not fucking with you.
Because
mm-hmm. the same way you're going to do it to him, you'll do it to us.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Like,
yeah.
I mean, come on,
that's
people.
The part they don't get.
Yeah, they only got to think.
And I didn't even have to say nothing.
No.
You know what I'm saying? When that incident was over, I was like, oh, okay. Then I got the address and said, come through. Okay,
yeah.
Thank you.
The universe takes care of its people, man. People
mm-hmm.
don't understand that, man.
It's interesting. But I always tell all the independent artists when I speak to them, if you really want to be successful, if you want a new store, you want a great building, you need to get some counseling to sort out what's going on
mm-hmm.
so that you can climb that ladder and deal with any adversities on the way.
Absolutely. T-Rex, let's get some Mr. Big by Joe Green and Bigger Rankin, man. Take a small pause for the calls on Conversations, man. Y'all keep it tuned right here, man. Tell a friend, tell a friend, and tell a friend, man. We here. That's what we do.
Say what? Say what? Say what? Come on, Sam. Yeah. Educated man from the motherland. You see, they call me a star, but that's not what I am. I'm a jungle brother, a true blue brother, and I've been to many places you'll never discover. Step to my side, suckers running hot. Africa's in the house, they get petrified. You wanna know why? I'll tell you why. Because they can't stand the sight of the jungle. They never fight a fuss, they never curse a cuss. They just stand on the side and stare at us. They get out of line, I put them on a vine and give them one big push for all mankind. There ain't nothing to it, I just go ahead and do it. I lay down the jungle sound and run right through it. And when I'm on the mic, I never stutter or stumble, cause I'm a jungle brother. Straight out the jungle.
Cool and quiet, but quick to start up a riot. I write the rhyme, bums insist to bite it. I wear no gold around my neck, just black medallions. I show the homes of three black stallions. I don't care for fear, cause fear fears me. Out of 10 ways of dying, the first Mike G. I'm harder than the hardest, hardest, hard can get. Africa and I was Sammy B's on the set. I kicked the rhyme to the girl and she became my pet. I left the sucker some juice and now he's still in debt. The sucker said he wasn't scared but still in all he sweat. A poor man became rich because of me he bet. My brother's searching high and low, they're looking for me. Where will they find me?
In the J-U-N-G-L-E.
It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under.
Struggle to live,
struggle to survive, struggle,
struggle,
just to stay alive. Cause inside the jungle, either you do or you die. You got to be aware, you got to have the jungle line. Take it from a brother who knows, my friend. The animals and cannibals will do you in.
Cut your throat,
stab you in the back.
The untamed animals just don't know how to act. It's unbelievable,
uncivilized.
And now I'm starting to realize the danger in the jungle. The jungle means danger. Tension intense, hearts filled with anger. Men killing men just because of one's color. In this lifetime, I see nothing dumber, so I think before I make a move, make sure my rhyme goes along with the groove. Never acting on a brother when it's time to rumble. My name's Mike G, and I'm straight out in the jungle.
Yo, this is MC Chill, the cause of all this commotion, and I'm tapped into DJ Shawnee Sean and the Bourbon Brothers. Talk to me.
I was legit. I knew I was gonna be bigger than the average nigga. I learned the rules of the streets. I learned how to flip and stack and wait my turn. I paid my dues. I earned my respect in this music game. I am bigger in these streets. I am Mr. B, right?
Twisted genius, baby.
Long live Mr. B, ho.
I was young as a motherfucker, fucked up on the block. My cousin Earth came through that 442 with the green top. At night I hit the club, we had belly ass asleep. Went inside the house, it wasn't that another. Then my partner started kicking, he was talking about the gate. Say his cousin to put us on, we can get some bread today. Walked up to his spot, he blessed us with a 50 slab. I was back at the door in an hour and a half. I gave him a dollar, he gave me something for the honor. Put a slab down, then I'm right back on the corner. Junkie walk up on me, give me something for the 10. Broke him off proper, then he came right back again. Look like what I'm doing, so he frontin' what I'm buying. Niggas start tripping, so I went and got a 9. Breaking down myself, I swear to God.
What up, DJ Shiny Shine and the Bourbon Brothers? Every Monday right here, WNRV 108.1 for conversation. 6 to 8 p.m. You never know what you're going to hear or what we're going to talk about, man. Tell a friend, tell a friend, tell their friends. Tap in.
This has been a very fun impromptu edition of conversation.
Yeah, absolutely.
So we got a lot of things that we need to update y'all on. Things coming up, changes. Y'all know we got a new address, new location. Same dopeness.
Big building.
Yeah.
Big same, windows.
Same dopeness.
Big bossness.
On steroids.
On steroids.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Ooh,
yeah.
We got muscles.
Stop it.
You
gotta have some control on your with this show.
Right.
You.
I don't.
She'll have a whole just orgasm a over there.
I said you got muscles. What is that? What that got? Take your mind
off. Hey, man, don't put that in my face.
Damn, squirt.
Y'all so stupid. I'm just being myself. I ain't said nothing.
Now, you know you in a different world with us. You
right,
know that,
you know
right?
Some fools up here.
I know. I ain't mad.
But no, it was dope, man. Super shout out to our sister Squirt in the building.
Hey.
Appreciate it.
Splashing appreciate on y'all. Y'all make sure y'all get y'all shit in order and get on that splash tour. Get your surfboards together.
Surfboards.
Ride the wave.
Hey. Okay, I like that.
Get your money up. Get your time together. Get your songs together. Get your quality. Get your mix and your master.
Get your mind right.
Because the opportunities are coming.
Yeah, so y'all going to be live performances, man.
You don't understand what's happening in this place.
Yeah, this is about to be the mecca.
Like when a we true say, complex.
Yeah, when we say independent artists, like y'all don't understand. Like nobody is really giving y'all what we giving y'all. Y'all going places to do stuff now that's not gonna take y'all nowhere. Mm-mm. This right here will be y'all the new proving grounds of 2024. Without competition, without breaking your budget, without giving you to run around and selling you dreams and false narratives. You ain't gotta drive to New York for them to tell you you did good, you was dope, and they checking for your music and send your ass right back to Cleveland.
Right.
With nothing.
Right. So.
You can literally start from A and end up at Z and underneath the same roof.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I mean.
Through the whole process.
And you never know who's going to be watching
you. The whole process.
And you never know who's going to be sitting in the audience watching you.
Right. Yeah.
And
you
will have an audience, and it will be organic. You ain't got to sell tickets and turn in money and all that wild shit.
Right.
It's 100% official. So when I said and we said that we was doing something major for independent artists in 2024, stay tuned. I promise you, stay tuned, man. You know, it was funny because I had this thing in the back of my mind. I wanted to say, man, Cleveland was the home of the biggest haters in the world.
They still here.
They still here. But, you know, my whole thing is, like, at the beginning of this year, I decided to change my mindset, my focus, and being more in tune with my peace and my energy. And, I just stopped paying a lot of shit attention.
Right,
so,
right.
You know, silence is louder than anything. So
all the time.
I just choose to be silent these days. Not stupid, not dismissive, not passive by any means, but silent.
Silent, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Purposely silent.
Yeah, you got to kind of be like.
To focus.
You have to have the patience of a Buddhist monk when you live in Cleveland.
I like how you put that.
Take a deep breath and
you have to have the
recess.
Of a Buddhist monk.
When it's bullshit, you just look the other way.
Mm-hmm.
Don't have to jump in there with the bullshit. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Let me put this shameless plug out there that the Nerve DJ Institute is wide open. And shout out to Campus International for letting us host their career fair for the second year in
a row. Absolutely.
Planting the seeds to change the minds of the youth and promise them futures and development of entrepreneurship. Mm-hmm. So, it's a whole plan. You know, shout out to Warrensville High School and Middle School for letting us come in and groom and educate and teach their youth.
Thank you.
Shout out to East Tech.
East Tech is jumping on board.
For letting us come in and change the lives of these youths. Shout out to the city of Cleveland for letting us come in and change the lives of their youths. Shout out to CMHA for letting us come in and
do
plant
what?
The seeds and change the lives of their youths. Shout out to the motherfucking Juvenile Detention Center for letting us come in
say
and plant
that
the seeds and change the lives of their
youths.
So it's again, it's no competition, man.
Under this roof.
It's no competition. Teamwork makes the dream work.
everybody focused.
It's a celebration of life every day your feet touch the floor. And if you're not waking up to celebrate life, then you should go to sleep and not wake up.
Just go to sleep.
Find your purpose, shit, man. You got mountains to move. You got shit to do. You sitting back worrying about what other people doing, that means you're not doing enough.
Yes.
Do more. Don't do what they doing. Do what you want to do. If you do what they doing, that means you're not doing enough because you're not paying enough attention to you.
Yep. Right.
If you're not that busy, if you're not booked, that means you're bored. Mm-hmm. Go find something productive to do. Mm-hmm. Stop calling people your brothers and doing backstabbing shit to them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, let's just stop it. Accountability breaks souls. And I've been saying this shit for the longest.
My man.
Accountability breaks souls. And a lot of y'all afraid to take accountability because y'all don't want to cry. It's okay to let them tears out. It's okay to be hurt. It's okay to admit that something's wrong. Like, instead of trying to create other shit to distract what's wrong with you, look inside of yourself and fix that shit. Because there's a part of you that's broken that needs some real serious healing.
Yeah.
And as long as you keep doing that shit, you never going to face your problems, man. Yeah. These are the things, like, you have to, don't wait till something in life lands at your feet and you got to figure it out. Like, fix that shit now. Yeah. While you can. Like, I'm not, y'all, I'm speaking this from existence, from personal experience. I had to be able to go through something, to come through something, to know where I'm going.
That's big. Yeah, yeah.
Let me repeat that again. It's like church on a Sunday.
Okay.
You got to go through something, to come through something, to get through something. You understand? It's a process. Like, stop blaming shit. Stop blaming people.
Like the side of you, Sean and Sean.
It's the truth.
It's the truth, though.
Like, these are the things, these are the conversations that men don't have. You know why?
Yeah.
Because we think with our pride, mm-hmm, instead of with our emotions. It's okay to be emotional.
Wow.
Like, I cry a lot, but I had to, because until you dig deep into yourself and find out what's hurting you in life, you don't know how to heal from
it's
it.
It's going to keep poking at you every time you get triggered.
So when people call you and, like, poke the bear, like, before I'd be like, man, blah, 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 blah. Like, I'm not that person anymore.
Yeah.
You don't get that from me no more.
Now it's,
that
side no longer exists.
You know why they poking the bear.
Yeah.
It's not that they poking the bear, you know why they poking
the
bear.
Yeah, and it's cool.
And that's a different understanding.
No, that's true.
That's
you're a different understanding.
Right.
True.
But understand, that bear is still in there.
Right.
That bear is still
in there. It come out when it needs to.
No, the bear that you will awaken on this time won't have no pause.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Won't have no filter. He's gonna maul you, mm-hmm, with no words, because you've already been warned. So if you try to awaken the demons of somebody that learned to come to peace with them,
exactly,
you messing with a whole different level of a person mentally.
Exactly.
You're not getting the same version of the person that you, mm-hmm, thought you were getting. Mm-hmm. You're getting a multiplied person of somebody that's very calculated in how they're going to destroy you on sight.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So you can't poke the bear, mm-hmm, because you don't know what that bear was doing during this hibernation phase.
Yeah. Right.
Where a lot of people don't think about that.
Yeah.
I am loving this side of you.
It's the truth, man.
You're just glowing like a light.
You gotta.
I'm serious.
You gotta be in touch with yourself. You gotta find it out, man. You gotta find it out. And I don't mind sharing my testimonies with people, because you know what? They my stories. They my stories. So I mean, they not everybody else's stories. Like, people rewrite your story and write you out of your own fucking story
in a heartbeat.
Yeah.
So look. I got a session called the Healing Hour, just for that.
Yeah, that's dope.
We need to have a session like you did with me. But I need that recording.
You need to have men on there. It's a lot of hurt and damaged men out here. Like, people
if
always
you express
saying,
it,
yeah.
That's why you need to hibernate, because you have to let it.
You have
hurt.
To. You have to
you
go
can't
away.
Keep pacifying. Yeah,
you have to go
hurt.
Away. You
let
have
it hurt
to disappear.
To the maximum pain, then let it heal over, and then it changes.
Yeah.
So when people come rubbing across that bruise, it don't hurt no more. But you know, you try to.
You recognize.
Yeah.
You know, I know what you're doing.
Okay.
You're trying to pull
right.
that scab off.
Right.
I got you.
You got to pull back. I'm like, okay, mm-hmm. Mom, you take
right.
care.
Right.
Yeah. I just let people, you know, mm-hmm, do whatever they feel is beneficial for them. It's not what they do to you. It's how you react.
It's how
to
you
it.
React.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're going to be my first guest. Would you like to be my first guest?
Half the battle is knowing who you're dealing with. The other half is how you react to
it. We need that.
Yeah.
We really need that.
Yeah.
And that's like you were saying, we're speaking on the other session regarding how people are behaving in the communities and how it's,
mm-hmm,
affecting,
absolutely,
everything. But if we get them to get healed, That'll change a whole lot.
I want people.
But they got to recognize the need to be healed first.
Right.
You know.
Exactly. But when they see someone like him.
Until you get to that point, then you just going through the motions.
When you see someone like him, and then he starts to speak on things that he did, you know how many people are going to resonate with what he's saying? That's going to change people too.
Yeah.
So.
Put him in a win.
Never mind.
Dead soldier.
Just leave it there.
Yeah. Man down.
Man down.
It took 18 years to get there.
An hour to kill him.
And four people put it to the
right. So. Oh, that's amazing. You're gonna be my first guest.
I'm cool with that.
No, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those.
Privately in the podcast area.
Yeah, it's one of those things where I think men, you know, and I would really like. I would really love, I'm not going to say like, I would love for, you know, like, this is what conversations like. Let me clear the air with this now.
Go ahead.
Conversations now moving forward in 2024 is not the conversations prior to us relocating.
Uh-oh. Right.
The conversations to us prior to us relocating were independent artist spotlight, you know, a couple guests coming through.
Yeah, yeah.
The focus would be on this time getting more back to the people and change. So it's about building, uplifting, and talking about things of value and substance. So we'll still have a lot of special guests on there, but every guest that comes on the show has a purpose and a place.
Yes.
So everybody that comes on there is back to, you know, day one where they have a conversation to be able to talk about things that they might not be so open about.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that us as men and people of color, we need to be able to tap into that side of ourselves because COVID, it gave us a lot of clouded judgment. Mm-hmm. They gave us a lot of closed doors versus open windows to let fresh air in. And I mean, the fresh air, I mean, as far as your life, because it kind of put us all in a box.
Mm-hmm.
It forced us to have to deal with the good, the bad, and different. Like COVID destroyed a lot of marriages.
Mm-hmm.
COVID destroyed a lot of jobs. It destroyed a lot of businesses.
Yeah.
But nobody ever instilled counseling after COVID to be able to balance this shit out. So now you got people that's road rage for no reason.
Oh my God.
Running through stop signs like they don't exist.
Yeah, right.
You know, killing kids, killing
a
women,
lot of
killing babies, a lot
for sure.
Undefined shit because people are still bottled up dealing with that shit.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? A lot of elderly people, listen, think about the amount of people that lost family members in nursing homes that didn't get a chance to say goodbye.
Mm-hmm.
That's real.
Nobody called them people and said, hey.
Yeah.
Do you need counseling? Like that's the true definition of PTSD.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody dealt with that.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody dealt with that.
And we're seeing it now.
Yeah, we're dealing
now,
with
now
it.
Now that the world is open again, you know, people, you know, we dealing with that portion.
You know what they
a lot of people.
You know what they did 90% of the time during COVID? They sold guns.
Yeah.
They sold everybody.
Yeah.
That was big.
Yeah,
was
anybody
big.
Who didn't have a felony party bought 3 to 5 guns during COVID. This is a fact. And now those guns that people bought because they're in everybody's hands, these are the guns that's being used out on the streets. It ain't about people talking about, you know, oh, these kids killing their kids. These kids, it's deeper
it's
than
the
that.
People. It's the people.
It's deeper than that. Like
yes,
I always told
yes,
people, I said,
yes.
Y'all, has anybody ever took the time to think that it's not kids killing kids?
Huh.
Mm-hmm.
It could be grown-ass groups or militia groups or people out here with these guns that don't see no value in our communities, and they know that nobody's going to check for them, nobody's going to pull those cameras, nobody's going to investigate that shooting these 13 and 14-year-old kids. Like, these not kids killing kids. When kids shoot guns recklessly, bullets go everywhere. These kids are being strategically hit in places where they don't survive.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's a marksman shop.
Mm-hmm.
That's a specific target. That's
right.
A target. That's not kids shooting
that's
wild.
That's an execution.
That's a hit. That's somebody in their spare time that said, you know what? They ain't checking for these people down here anyway.
So why not?
Yeah. We need to keep the violence rate high so we can keep the property value down so we can go in and buy out their neighborhoods.
Yeah.
It's something it could be that simple.
It's
too.
a bigger picture involved.
You gotta look at it, man.
Always throw these distractions out there.
I guarantee you that people don't know that 80% of the urban neighborhood empty houses are owned by corporations versus other
it
people.
Sure is.
And this is why the housing
outside
market is so depleted.
Kind of
by the city too.
And look what they're buying it for. They're buying it for
land
taxes.
Land bank is killing it.
But you can't.
Is killing it.
But you, me, or any one of
we
us can go online
it.
And buy that property.
Yeah.
We can't.
And we live in the same
we
county.
We, We can stay around the corner from it.
Yeah, right. And they won't touch us. They won't touch us.
You can buy it, but they're going to put you through so much shit that
it's not even. You aren't even going to go through that. You're not going to go through that.
You won't even own it until that house is like a 5-star
exactly
property.
Exactly. Right, right, yeah. Or even one better, if you don't have a representation of a person that don't look like you with the credentials in place to go in and buy without all that red tape, you're not gonna own that property.
It's not. Mm-hmm.
A whole lot of stipulations.
Yeah, East Cleveland, Circle East.
Yeah, shit, St. Clair, really? Kinsman Avenue, Buckeye
that's
Avenue.
That's the new title for Circle East.
Wow, they're gonna make it top notch quality homes up in there. They about to really upgrade them areas. Wow.
Yeah.
Oh hell yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And all this time, black people was told like live in this whatever, but at the same time, property value go down, people move out.
Yeah,
and
move on to the next.
Right.
Yeah,
I mean, and
ship
and
them out,
and I can't
move them in.
No, I can't get no black people to buy anything in East Cleveland because of the stigma.
The stigma.
But
yeah.
Somebody from New York, all these Mexicans that's coming across the border, where you think they coming? Sure. What you think they getting at?
Yeah, right.
Those
jumping all over.
Are like $20,000, and they're like, they're structured like mansions, and all they got to do is just go to Home Depot and clean up a couple things. And a lot of that stuff even have asbestos in it, but they're not checking for that.
Nope, and they started a class online right now for $80 where you can get your lead abatement and asbestos removal certification.
Yeah.
$80.
It's 120 hour course.
Yep.
Something like that. $80. It doesn't take long. Yeah.
Nope.
Yeah.
Right. You don't even got to step foot in there.
They don't be wanting to work.
Right.
Huh?
They don't be wanting to work. That's
5-day course. Yeah. Imagine that.
But right. I mean, but to get rid of asbestos costs almost $1 million, depending on
the square footage of it.
If you got that certification, you can go in there and probably change your whole life by doing one job.
That's all it takes.
But it be them people that don't live here get those opportunities because they know they're being told about it.
Yep.
Like we're not being told about it.
And then if somebody tells us about it, we don't try to spread the information or try to pull together.
Come back to the hood and the bins.
Are we going
to
talk so bad about it? Right.
That part. Yeah, right, right, right.
That's not cheering.
If you can't do it, get six or seven other people that come together as a unit and do something.
But that's what
nobody wants to go that route.
That's what I want to talk about. What's the place over there on St. Clair? Omar Seafood? Like, I felt so bad about that, them people. And I'm going to tell you why. That place been there as a stakeholder for St. Clair for as long as I can remember.
Omar,
right past that place, has been there. Now, when they lost that place or when it caught on fire, the people in the community didn't pull together and say, hey, man, let's have a community awareness fundraiser to rebuild Omar's or put this place back. Only on the strength because it's our neighbor. They look like us. They, you know what I'm saying, they take care of us. You know what they said? They went on social media and got in the comments and said, they fool was trifling anyway. That fool was mad. Don't nobody go there. This is what we do to our own people.
So these are black people that own
it? Yeah. No. Yeah.
Yeah, and I've been there before. So the food was right.
Yeah.
It was good.
It's still original owners from.
I thought it changed hands.
And I got a funny story. Before Omar's, my auntie used to take me there to get our live turkey there.
Yeah.
Oh, that food was good.
The fish place. Yeah, cut
the turkey off. We used to eat that for Thanksgiving every year. That was crazy.
And then our own people destroy our own people. We won't help rebuild, but we'll help destroy it without a blink of an eye. You will never be there in a place in your life, but you got a whole opinion. This is why I think. If you get rid of the comment section on social media, people will pull.
People will cut it off.
They'll
be done.
People
with
cut it
media.
Off.
Yeah.
They'll They'll cut it off. If you can't cut it, if you don't have an opinion, you don't have a place to state your opinion. You could just see shit. People wouldn't be interested in it.
But this
because somebody gonna jump on that instant gratification of, ooh, I'm getting some attention.
Or they gonna tear it down.
You know,
that's
why the internet is bad. I mean, this thing in high school, you have college prep. General classes.
Yeah, shadowing experience.
AP classes.
Right.
Slow
right,
kids
right.
in the basement.
Mac, we had
I'm
not trying to be funny, but I get where you're
at though,
right.
I mean, everybody wasn't, it was class, you know? Now the people that was in the basement, they talking the most on social media, which is hilarious.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. That's sad, it's right, man. The people who wouldn't even get picked or couldn't climb a rope or shoot a jumper. These are the people that run the world now.
We got a platform for you.
Yeah.
They
didn't put a whole role reverse, so the bullies is bitches now.
Yeah.
In a nutshell.
Yeah, the bullies is bitches.
Right. Yeah.
And it happens overnight.
It
happens overnight.
They
Yeah. The punks are our political campaign.
Yeah, they winning.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
They're winning.
Yep. It is real, though.
It's crazy, man. Like, I look at the world through a whole different pair of glasses, man. Then
it's nice awakening. You have that shadow work done. You got to pull that dark out of you. Like, I always say that, too. This group home kid jump out. It's all over.
Stupid.
She's still in there.
Stop.
She's still in there. But I'm saying, you also have to learn that, you know, every action has a reaction.
And like being able to recognize it.
You don't get away with
nothing.
Yeah. So nothing. Super games wins super prizes.
Mine shouldn't be to revenge or hurt.
Yeah.
Or
yes.
I mean, I remember I used to be the one, oh, I'm going to get that bitch.
Yeah, right,
oh,
right.
Oh, hell
right.
No. When I see her, I'm going to bust her head wide. Maybe. You know. But I had to learn
reacting without thinking.
See,
yeah,
that's
not taking you nowhere.
The devil confusion. And the devil comes to kill and destroy. So if he can make you put yourself in line in the path to get that karma, then that you got two birds with one stone.
Yeah,
that's true.
So you have to learn when somebody coming at you negatively like that or pushing your body, making you holler back at them too, you just put yourself right in line with their ass.
Mm-hmm.
So now, I'll be like, oh, you so ugly. Yep. Thank you.
Look,
thank you so much.
Might not have won, but they didn't
thank
either.
You.
And they keeping you in the same space that they don't want to see you progress.
You took their power from them.
You win by not reacting.
Yeah, you win by not reacting.
Yeah, right.
Just thank you. Like, you all that. You ain't no, they ain't going to never. Okay.
Yep.
But look, I work. Yeah. And I've been like that since I was a teenager. Mm-hmm. I'm a hustler and not a hustle to hustle nobody to get where I want to be.
Say that. Say that.
But now that I'm clear on the inside and I see, when that phrase, I was blind, but now I see, oh my God, I see things
big.
So clearly.
It's big.
I should just see it from right here. I got this. But now it's like, oh, wait a minute.
It's a bigger picture.
Yeah.
You feel me?
And when the picture becomes bigger, you realize it's not about you.
As soon as
you
see them,
you just a blip on the radar.
And then you move differently.
Yeah.
You move so differently.
And then when you see
them
people come, you doing something right when they're coming at you like that.
But that's why I tell kids all the time now, like, I think the most important message, and I think people should put this on their children's bedroom walls, they should make this a mantra in their homes. They should make this what their kids should say in school, versus trying to say the fucking national anthem or morning grace. If you count to 10 before you react, it might save your life.
That's true.
That's the
big
mantra.
Very true.
If
like
you
that.
Count to 10
that's
before big. You react, you might save your
count
life.
To 10. If somebody hear you count to 10, they need to know to chill out because you done upset and just wait.
Yeah.
Well, it's just, even if you count to it, even if you count to your head, that's somebody, a person don't know how to deal with you after that.
Because
it's like, damn, I just slapped this person. Which is one of the most degrading things you could do other than spitting on somebody. But if a person stand there
reaction.
And counted to 10 and exhaled and walked away, you just live to see another day.
You're going to demoralize that one person.
Slap
a
felonious assault?
Yeah.
I don't know, though.
What did you say?
Is a slap felonious assault?
Oh, you know what?
I don't think so.
Let us know next week.
If you slap them with something, then yes. If you slap them with your hand, they
open hand.
Know.
If you spit on somebody, that's a felonious assault.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
But I think it didn't become that till after COVID, right?
That's disgusting.
Huh? It didn't come that till after, HIV?
Some folks like that.
I'm going to say, late 90s.
Yeah, it's after HIV.
Some folks like that.
Yeah, I think that became a felonious assault after HIV.
I couldn't help it. That was too easy. It was too easy, Squirt. I couldn't help it.
Yeah, that's different, man. So, I mean, yeah, I tell people that all the time, man. Before you react, count to 10. By the time you get to 10, you done de-escalated so much to the point that it ain't even worth it.
It's
like,
easy
you know
to,
what?
You know what?
You can have
you
it.
You can have that. Yeah. You can have that. Yeah.
You win.
Yeah. Yeah.
You feel better now?
Yeah, because if I know for a fact that if I take off out of reaction, there's no stopping me.
But
and
not
I'm not going to fuck up my whole life
because you lined yourself up with they dumbass when they going down karma. You being dragged right with them.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So you see it that way?
Yeah.
They're nothing
and
about
it's doing
you.
Nothing.
Yeah, I gave you a pass.
You old ass lady, you ain't think. I look damn good to be 53.
How you think I get
okay.
How you think I got here? Right.
Yeah. It's not, you know, I think that in my head. I don't say it out loud because, you know, the group home kid's still in there. If I start, you know, like you said, I don't know.
Right.
But no, I just kind of, okay, I just let that roll off because that don't mean nothing to me. That ain't got nothing to do with what I'm doing. But we got to pray for these people. That's all.
So, quick question for you. Is there a bourbon thing or cigar spot happening too here?
So we'll talk about that.
I just
want to toss that up there and I'm gonna walk away
on the next episode.
Throw that up there and walk away.
So again, we go back to growth and expansion and things.
You know, just toss it out in the air and then walk away.
Just understand that when we say there was a whole major change and a shift, and you know, you have to do things silently so they can be accomplished, and you don't speak upon them until the ground has been broken and the cement has been poured.
Right, right.
So once the foundation has been poured, then we'll make those specific announcements. So in the meantime, you know, let people keep guessing. You know, they thought we moved and fell off and was out here and homeless, you know.
The one thing that caught me, I heard somebody, where was I? I'm not going to say where I was at, but I was somewhere where we were together, me, you, and John.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a side conversation and, you know, club style over with.
Yeah.
I heard that. Like,
yeah. Haters. Club,
you know, and I'm like, wow. You know, I don't really know what's going on, but, you know, it's just reruns.
Let people
they
assume.
Club styles, yeah, they ain't even asking.
You got a rerun tonight, though.
They ain't even asking nobody to come on no more. Club style, I think it's dead, man. Yeah. I don't think it's happening.
I was
like, wow.
That's because they want you to say
I
something.
I was like, I was standing right there. I refused. I just kept bobbing my head to the music. I just kept bobbing my head to the music. I never stopped. But I heard every word they said.
Let me give you a grain of salt with this, with that statement.
Be nice.
I'm going to be very nice because I'm nice these days. So the grain of salt that I'm going to give you with that statement is, you know, it costs you nothing to mind your own business.
Not a damn thing.
Yeah, that's just the bottom line. I mean, it's just that simple because when people say things like that, it's like they're looking for a reaction.
Right. Well,
they don't know who to talk to. They know who they could talk to, but they don't have the balls to call.
Mm. Whoa. Mm. Say it again.
They know who they could talk to, but they don't have the balls to call.
Yeah, they be trying.
So, I mean, you know, you talk to different people, you get different stories. But when you want to know the truth straight from the horse's mouth, you ain't bold enough to bark up that tree. Because they could have called John.
The answer all the same. They all saying the same thing.
Yeah. That goes to show you that we move as one. We're a unit, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We're a unit. And it's just that simple.
Yeah.
We're a unit, man.
We represent and hold each other down.
Yeah,
well.
We ain't gonna have a conversation about you without you. You know what I mean? We don't do that. We don't have conversations about you without you.
Right. Yeah.
If it's something that we want to know, we'll call you. And if we all need to know collectively, we'll conference call your ass. Or we'll send you a Zoom link. And we'll wait till everybody on the line and then we'll ask you.
Yeah.
You know, we don't speculate or go around talking about other grown ass men or grown ass women. We don't do that.
That is so crazy.
Yeah, it's bigger. It's bigger. This world is a humongous place, man. And I'm in the mindset of manifestation as I've always been, that I said that I can have everything that I want and I'm going to take everything that I'm coming for. Mm-hmm. And hell, y'all sitting at home and y'all see it right now. It's taking shape right in front of your eyes.
I have no idea. Me either.
Man, when you got a room full of anointed people, you don't worry about what the people on the outside are saying. You just don't. I keep telling y'all, this is the Financial Church of Prosperity.
I am just
y'all need to come on in.
Church been around for a minute, though. You understand?
Yeah. But I am loving the spirit of Shawnee Sean.
Trying to tell you, man. It's a beautiful place to be in life. when the blessings come in abundance, man, there's nothing you can do to stop it. There ain't an umbrella big enough to block these blessings, baby. I'm trying to tell you.
He ready, ain't he?
Pastor
Sean. Is he ready?
Sean.
Is he ready, too?
Ready, Sean in the building.
Is he ready?
Pass that plate around.
Not the Kavassier, pass the plate.
Y'all send y'all tithes and offerings to 216-702-0688.
Pass
that plate. Cash App, Zelle, PayPal. That number will connect you there, but that's it.
Yes.
Venmo, I got you, baby.
Next.
Money orders.
Yeah. I will say a prayer for you. I will reach out and touch you in places that you have not known about. Spiritually. Spiritually.
I was like, ooh, that took a bad change.
Spiritually.
That's them other churches now. Stop
it, Squirt.
Spiritually.
I didn't do nothing.
Stop it, Squirt. You going somewhere else, Squirt.
I didn't do that.
Spiritually.
It wasn't even me. I was saying no stressing in the blessing. That's
be nice.
Oh,
okay.
That's what I said.
Sure.
Ain't nothing about no baptisms.
No. We ain't play Betty Wright. Tonight is the night.
Oh.
I know you're not going to sing that song.
But we slid it by. Yes, we did.
Oh, my God. That's crazy.
Man, this was This was great.
Yeah, man.
This was great.
Shout out to Elijah Craig, single barrel, 18 year.
Shout out to Elijah Craig.
Shout out to Guys Pizza. Shout out to y'all, man, for rocking with us, believing in us, hanging out with us, knowing that bigger things to come. They're yours if you want some.
Jesus.
Shout out to the engineer extraordinaire, the human T-Rex over there.
One and only.
Shout out to DJ Big Jew, the biggest nigga in town.
Oh,
shout out to DJ 88, class of 88.
Yes, sir.
Shout out to the Grand Wizard, the legendary DJ Johnny O. That's right.
How about that?
Leader, mentor.
Echo means a lot of space.
Yeah. Yeah. The janitor.
The janitor. Oh, he got a new
name. I tell everybody, if you're not willing to be the janitor, how you going to be a boss?
That's real.
If you ain't willing to be the janitor, how you going to be a boss?
That says a lot.
Now when you push the broom in your own building, that say something. Tell you something.
I gotta catch you.
Shout out to DJ Squirt in the building. Shout out to Sister Squirt.
Yeah.
She on the
Usher board
for hanging out with us tonight.
She on the Usher board.
Right.
Not the
she on the Usher
the
board.
Usher board.
She on the Usher board.
You gotta reconform your whole mouth when you say that.
She on the Usher
board. Usher board.
Usher board. She gonna say prayers for the sick and the shut in.
I gotta go. I can't.
Wow. I have nothing to say against that. Nothing.
So, you know, man, and like we always say, man, I'm gonna take a phrase from Happy Hour because it's real talk, man. If it's too heavy for you to pick up, sit it down, man. Give it to the man upstairs. He'll place it right where it needs to be. Live, love, laugh, cry if you have to because it's good for the soul. If you want it, speak it into existence, manifest it because it's yours. It costs you absolutely nothing to mind your own business, man. So until next time, man, take care of each other and one another and love and hug your kids, man. Call somebody and tell them that you love them. If nobody called and told you today, I love you. All right? Till the next time, man, on behalf of myself, the Bourbon Brothers, DJ Squirt, the Human T-Rex, the Grand Wizard, DJ 88, Big Jew, and myself, man, we love y'all. Stay safe. Stay hydrated. Peace.
We out.
I ain't no joke. I used to let the mic smoke. Now I slam it when I'm done and make sure it's broke. When I'm gone, no one gets on, cause I won't let nobody press up and mess up the scene I set. I like to stand in a crowd and watch the people wonder, damn. But think about it, then you understand. I'm just an addict, addicted to music. Maybe it's a habit, I gotta use it. Even if it's jazz or the quiet storm, I hook a beat up, convert it into hip-hop form. Write a rhyme and graffiti in every show you see me in. Deep concentration, cause I'm no comedian. Jokers are wild, if you wanna be tame. I treat you like a child and you're gonna be named another enemy, not even a friend of me. Cause you'll get fried in the end when you pretend to be competing. Cause I just put your mind on pause and I complete when you compare my rhyme with yours. I wake you up and as I stare in your face, you seem stunned. Remember me, the one you got your idea from. But soon you start to suffer, the tune'll get rougher. When you start to stutter, that's when you had enough of fighting, it'll make you choke. You can't provoke, you can't cope. You should've broke because I ain't no joke. Joke. As serious as cancer. Who can keep the average dancer hyper as a heart attack? Nobody's smiling, cause you're expressing the rhyme that I'm styling. This is what we all sit down and write. You can't make it, so you take it home, break it and bite. Use pieces and bits of all my hip-hop hits. Get the style down, packed, then it's time to switch. Put my tape on pause and add some more to yours. Then you figured you're ready for the neighborhood chores. The E-M-C-E-E, don't even try to be. When you come up to speak, don't even lie to me. You like to exaggerate, dream and imaginate. Then change the rhyme around, that could aggravate me. So when you see me come up, freeze, or you'll be one of those seven MCs. They think that I'm a new jack, but only if they knew that. They who think wrong, or they who can't do that style that I'm doing, they might ruin patterns of paragraphs based on you. And you all be DJ if anything he play sound familiar. I'll wait till E say play him. So I'ma have to diss who broke. You can get a smack for this. I ain't no joke. The microphone like a grudge, be a whole record so the needle don't budge.
I hold a conversation, cause what I invent, I nominated my DJ the president. When I'm C, I'll keep a freestyle going steadily. So pucker up and whistle my melody. But whatever you do, don't miss one. There'll be another rough rhyme after this one. Before you know it, you're following it, fiending, waiting for the punchline to get the meaning. Like before, the moral of my story I'm telling. Nobody beats the art, so stop yelling. Save it, put it in your pocket for later. Cause I'm moving the crowd and be a record fader. No interruptions till the mic is broke. When I'm gone, then you can joke. Cause everything is real on a serious tip. Keep playing, and I get furious quick. And I take you for a walk through hell. Freeze your dome, then watch your eyeballs swell. Guide you out of triple stage darkness. When it get dark again, then I'ma spark this microphone. Cause the heat is on, you see smoke in the finish when the beat is gone. I'm no joke, no joke, no joke.